I'm Louise from SuperHigh, and in this video, I'm going to explain how to get started with variable fonts. Open type font variations, better known as variable fonts, is a technology that allows a font to be fine-tuned in an infinite number of ways. Maybe you want your design to include a font that is almost, but not quite bold, or a little bit slanted, but not fully italic. If that's the case, variable fonts are your new best friend. Variable fonts work with axes and instances. Each different kind of variation within a font is defined on an axis which has a minimum, maximum, and default value. The combined set of axes is called the design space. Once I've set a value on one or more axes, the result is referred to as an instance. The most common axes available are weight, width, italic, slant, and optical size. But type designers can create their own custom font-specific axes too. Not all variable fonts come with all axes included, so to check which axes your font has, there are a few helpful tools on the web you can try. One is Wacamai Fondue by Rowan Nukinsons, and in this tool you can download a font, drag and drop it onto the site, and it will then be shown all the features your font includes, and even how to use some of them. Let's look at an example. I'm going to demo how to change the weight of a font. So first, we need to find a font containing the weight axis. I'm going to use a Google font. So to find out which Google fonts are variable fonts, I'm going to head over to this link. And let's have a look. I think I'm going to pick Josephine Sans here. If you know the exact weight you want your font to be, Google Fonts actually provides a tool at the bottom of each variable font page where you can select the weight you want and then add the font to your project using the instructions on the right. Let's have a go. I'm going to jump over to Code Sandbox, and you can too by following the link in the top right hand corner. Here I've got a basic static site set up, including a HTML file and a style sheet. Inside our HTML, we have some identical paragraph text, which we'll alter the weight of once we've added a font to our project. Okay, let's head back to Google Fonts. I'm going to copy and paste the code into the head of our file. And notice that in the URL, we have the name of the axis, weight, and the value we set it to with the slider, 483. This URL actually fetches only one specific weight at the moment. For our project, we want to play around with several different font weights, so we need to update the URL so it instead loads a range from the weight axis. Let's try using weights 200 to 700. So all we need to do here is remove 483 and instead add 200, dot dot, and then 700. Now we can use any weight between those two values. Now we need to apply it in our CSS. I'm going to apply the font to the whole page inside of the body tag. If we do nothing else, the font weight we originally chose will be applied everywhere. To change the weight axis in CSS, we can use the font weight property. I can set the font weight to a value between 200 and 700. So we've got three pieces of paragraph text here. Let's apply a different font weight to each one. I'm going to start with primary. Let's add 320. For secondary, I'm going to add, let's do 582. And finally, let's make highlight the boldest. So I'm going to apply 700. Okay, I'm going to save by using the keyboard shortcut, Command or Control and S. And awesome, we can see that our variable fonts are working and we're able to set the weight axis to whichever value we want. So remember, to use a variable font axis, first check that your font includes the axis you want to use, then add it to your project, adjusting the URL if necessary. You can then apply the font where you'd like to show it using the font family property. And if you're adjusting the weight axis, you can use font weight to set it to a value that you like.